everyone, I'm Roshni and welcome to Medical Dialogue, daily dose of health and medical news. Here is today's top news from the health world. September Delhi cases lowest in 6 years, Delhi government keeping guard up, says Health Minister Satendra Jain. Delhi's Health Minister Satendra Jain on Wednesday said that September 2021 has recorded the least number of dengue cases when compared to the same period in the last 6 years. The number of dengue cases recorded up till now is the lowest in comparison to the previous years, he said. Delhi government has been taking preventive measures to keep the spread of dengue under control, especially the launch of Das Hafte Das Din Das Minute campaign to spread awareness about dengue has been successful for the past 2 years. Delhiites have been cooperative to not leave stagnant water around residential areas unattended for the mosquitoes to breed. WHO okays antibody treatment for high-risk COVID-19 patients. WHO Guideline Development Group panel of international experts and patients has recommended a treatment combining two antibodies, Castatinomab and Imdivimab, for two specific groups of patients with COVID-19, namely high risk of hospital admission and for severely ill patients who have no natural antibodies to COVID-19. The first recommendation is based on new evidence from 3 trials that have not yet been peer-reviewed, but show that two antibodies will probably reduce the risk of hospitalization and duration of symptoms in those at highest risk of severe disease. The second recommendation is based on data from the recovery trial showing that these two antibodies probably reduce deaths. The recommendations are part of a living guideline developed by WHO with the methodological support of Magic Evidence Ecosystem Foundation to provide up-to-date, trustworthy guidance on the management of COVID-19 and help doctors make better decisions with their patients. Supreme Court issues notice on plea seeking inspection of answer sheets, re-evaluation of AIIMS PG online entrance exam. Agreeing to consider a plea to determine whether a candidate of AIIMS online postgraduate entrance examination would be entitled to inspection of answer sheets, the Supreme Court on Monday issued notice to concerned parties. The issue of the case pertains to whether a candidate who has appeared at the online entrance exam for admission to the post-graduation course conducted by the AIIMS, which is an institution of national importance, would be entitled to inspection of the answer sheets and to re-evaluation when such a provision does not exist in the applicable regulations. Considering the plea, the Madras High Court bench comprising of Justice N. Anand Venkatesh on 27 August had directed the Controller of Examination AIIMS for submitting a detailed affidavit and explain the process along with the stand of the authorities regarding the inspection of answer sheets. 50 MBBS seats to be added at AMU's Jawaharlal Nehru Medical College after an MC inspection. In a major milestone, the Jawaharlal Nehru Medical College affiliated with the Aligarh Muslim University has received approval from the National Medical Commission to add another 50 MBBS seats. The final approval in this regard, however, would come after an NMC team visits the college to conduct an inspection. With this, the total number of MBBS seats in the college would be increased from 150 to 200. Meanwhile, the UP Nurses and Midwives Council, in accordance with the notification of the Indian Nursing Council, has permitted the upgradation of General Nursing and Midwifery course conducted by JNMC to a BSc Nursing degree with an intake of 20 students. India to not buy Pfizer Moderna COVID-19 vaccines. India's government will not buy COVID-19 shots from Pfizer and Moderna. The Indian government has also declined to meet the US company's request for legal protection over any side effects from the use of their shots, which are currently made only in the United States or Europe. Both vaccines cost several times more than India's main shot, Covishield, a licensed version of the AstraZeneca drug. India's monthly domestic output has tripled since April and will reach 300 million doses in October, according to Health Minister Mansukh Mandavia, who on Monday announced a restart of India's vaccine exports from the October quarter. The government, however, is expected to buy locally filled and finished doses of Johnson & Johnson's vaccine.
Never miss a medical update from Medical Dialogues. Like, subscribe and press the bell icon.